The standoff in Parliament is here to find a lasting solution. Following the bizarre events that saw Parliament adjourn prematurely yesterday, and today the House returned and the Deputy Speaker issued stricter conditions to dictate the new normal in the House.
From today and onwards, appealing to the lenience, to the flexibility of the Speaker, I have decided that that one will no longer apply to me.
The opposition, led by their leader Mathias Mpuuga, bounced back with a new list of conditions to be fulfilled for them to sit comfortably in the House. Mpuuga cited the fate of the suspended legislators, the change of the order paper, and heightened security presence around Parliament.
Our space, our house is not safe, that we are actually surrounded. They're surrounded by the military, including vehicles in which some of us were dumped during the Tojikwatako debate, and their surrounding Parliament.
That I have not ordered for any extra security at Parliament, and it's not necessary. There is nothing that warranted that.
Mpuuga insisted that they can't sit in a toxic environment surrounded by security, which resurrects memories of 2017, when security agencies stormed the House and beat up legislators who were against the presidential age limit removal from the Constitution. He led his troops out of the chambers in protest.
And I think it's adequate enough for me to now honorably take leave. Thank you.
The opposition retreated to the leader of opposition's boardroom, where they addressed the press on their grievances and their resolve to fight for human rights for political actors.
For a fact that their acts have no space in law and common sense, and therefore they require an unequivocal apology and a commitment that those acts will never occur again.
Earlier, security had stopped journalists from accessing the chambers until the Deputy Speaker's office intervened and doors to the gallery were opened. In the same vein, the Mukono Municipality legislator Betty Namboze, who is among the five legislators that were suspended after yesterday's impasse for three sittings, was blocked from entering Parliament today.
I was stopped. The officer in charge of the main gate told me that she was consulting with the sergeant at arms to establish if I'm allowed inside.
Namboze was stopped at the gate. She said she had come to seek clarification from the speaker on which Namboze was suspended, since the House has two legislators sharing that name. She noted that she reviewed the speaker's decision on suspension and discovered that he did not mention her both names, thus creating suspense.
He read out the name Namboze without specifying which numbers he was talking about. There are two people in particular in Parliament with the same name, numbers.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.